Welcome to this session on integration of Catalan Studio with Jenkins. This session is going to be very interesting and very easy. In this session, we are going to see how do we download and start Jenkins. We will create a job in Jenkins. We will add our Catalan Studio commands, and then we will run and validate our test. We will also look at some useful tips towards the end of this session. Let us start. And the very first prerequisite is we should have Jenkins installed on our system. So the very first thing we have to do is we have to download and start Jenkins, and we can do this in two very easy ways. The first one is we have to download Jenkins from this site. So let us go to our browser, and I'm saying download Jenkins, and you will get this site jenkins.io. I'm going here, and here you can hit on download Jenkins, and you can take this long-term stable release. So you can directly go to this var file and click here. It will download the jenkins.var on your system. I'm going to cancel this because I already have it, and you can see jenkins.var file is downloaded. So we have done step one, and now we have to start Jenkins. So for that, you have to go to your command prompt or terminal and go to the location of your var file and run the command java-jar-jenkins.var. So let us go to the terminal. In case you are on Windows, you will go to your command prompt and you will do the same actions. Let us go to our location of var file. In my case, I have placed my var file inside desktop. I have a folder called desktop as well, and then inside that I have a tools Jenkins, and here is my var file. So now I will say java space hyphen jar space jenkins.var, and this command should start Jenkins on your local machine. So let's wait for the message. Jenkins is fully up and running, and yes, we have this message here now. So now you can go to your browser and you can say localhost 8080. 8080 is the default port where Jenkins has started. We can change the port as well, but for now let us go to our localhost 8080, and it should start our Jenkins. And yes, so this is the dashboard for Jenkins. So we have now started our Jenkins. Now in case you are completely new to Jenkins, I have a separate playlist and series on Jenkins, which is very easy. In case you are complete beginner, you can watch that. And for this session, you can watch the very first video, which is Introduction to Jenkins. Here you will come to know exactly what is Jenkins, why do we use it, how do you download and start Jenkins. I will make the URL of this video available below in the description section. So you can go to my channel on YouTube and you will find a playlist for Jenkins here. So just go here and you have all these videos. The first one you can watch for this particular session in case you are completely new to Jenkins. So now we have our Jenkins up and running. We have to start our job or create our first job in Jenkins. So let us do that. Let us go to our Jenkins, and you have this create new job, or you can also go here, new item. And here you can enter any name. So let me say Catalan test suite run. And this is going to be a freestyle project. So let me click here. And now I will say OK. So now we have to add some details for our job. So this is the project name. You can add any description or keep it blank, and then you have to go to directly to the build and add build step. So here, in case you are on Mac, you will say execute shell. In case you are on Windows, you will say execute Windows batch command. So for now, I'm going to execute shell, and here I have to add my command. So in the last session, we have already seen how do we generate a command in Catalan Studio. So you will go to Catalan Studio, go to this build CMD, and then you will select your test suite. You will select your browser, and the other reports and other things. We have already seen this in our last session. And then you will say generate command. And this is the command that we have to use, the same command we will use in our Jenkins. And we also know that before using this command, we have to go to the location of our Catalon executable. So in Mac, I have to go to applications and then run the same command. In case of Windows, you have to go to the location where your catalon.exe is. The same thing we have seen in our last session. So I'm going to do the same thing. I will add this command in Jenkins, which is going to my applications folder, and then the command generated by Catalon Studio, this one. So I'll paste it here. And then I can just echo something. That's it. So this is what we have to do. The same command you are going to use for running your Catalon Studio project from command line, the same command we are using here. And then you can say apply and save. So you can see our, if you go to the dashboard, you can see our job has been created. Okay, so we have created the job in Jenkins. We have already added the Catalon Studio commands in the job. So now we have to run and test our job. So for that, you can either go to this drop down and say build now. You can also go inside the job, clicking here, and then from here, you can say build now. So I'm clicking here, and then I'm also going to look at the console output. So yes, it is running the command. And yes, it is running our test suite one on the Chrome browser, and you can see it has opened the Chrome browser and running our test. And it is done. Let us go back to our Jenkins and see. Yes, yeah, see, it is sending the email. And it is completing the execution. And yes, you can see it has finished, right? So now you can go back to the dashboard, and here you will find, if you go back to your project, you can see it has one run which was triggered at this particular time and it was successful, right? And then there are many other options that you can do with your job, which we will see in the later sections. But we were able to run our test and validate our job in Jenkins. Now, in case you are a complete beginner and new to Jenkins, you might get a question that what difference did it make running our Catalon Studio commands from Jenkins. We are still running the same command. We are still on our local system. The only difference is instead of running a command directly on the command prompt, we are using a tool. So we will look into it in the coming sessions. Now we can run scheduled tests. So if you go to your Jenkins, and I'm going to configure this job, and here if you go inside the build trigger section, you have this option build periodically. And if you go here, you can also click on this question mark, which will give you the cron expression of how you can schedule your job periodically. So this basically means is, in case you want to run your job or this particular test at some specified interval or some specified period, you can give the expression here accordingly, and then you can schedule it so it will run on some scheduled time. So that is one advantage we get with Jenkins. The second one is we can run a test after a Git commit. So for example, you are working in a team and you want that whenever somebody changes your project or makes any change or commit in the project, there should be a test triggered after that so that you can validate everything is okay. And then the most important is now we can integrate with the CI or continuous integration process. We will look into it into more detail in the coming sessions, but integration with any CI tool like Jenkins gives us a lot of power and a lot of flexibility. Let us look at some useful tips. So one of the things that you should always do is when you are generating your command in the Catalan Studio, keep this particular option, keep console log after execution completed as off. So here, if you go to your command generator, here is the option. Keep this off so that when you add your command in Jenkins, it gets completed properly. It does not wait for the execution and the logs. Let us do a very quick recap. Today we learned how do we download and start Jenkins, how do we create a job in Jenkins, and then how do we add our Catalan Studio commands in Jenkins, and then we ran and validated our test. In the next session, we will see how do we integrate with Git.